Okay. Are we ready? Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Ranta. It seems like we're ready. I feel like, thank you girls for being here. It seems like we're ready, except we seem to be missing a huge section of people. And I don't know if they're back there, where they are. I have no idea. Anybody in the back?
Let's go to the beach, eat, let's go get away.
On that. Okay, it looks like everybody's here, but I'm not sure that everybody is here. So I need to do a little roll call, as we always do, first day of school. And we're going to start, it's a very wonderful sight from up here, but we're going to start with the fifth grade, our newest honey bears in fifth grade. We're going to go through each class, and you all are free to scream and tell me that you're here. Not like we usually act in assembly, but it's okay today. So fifth grade, are you here? Are you ready? Okay, because this is all new to you, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna do it again because we get to do a do-over, okay? So it's just the fifth grade that are gonna make as much noise as you can. Fifth grade, are you here? I mean, they are quick. Well done, well done. Sixth grade, are you here and ready? Nice. Got a new octave on that one. Seventh. Okay, let's be quiet and see if the seventh grade is here. Seventh grade. Nice. Eighth grade. Ninth grade. Tenth grade. Okay, juniors? I don't know. Are you here? Seniors, class of 2020. I love it. I'm so glad you're all here. Good to know. Welcome to our opening convocation for the 2019-2020 school year from what I've seen and what I've heard about our retreats and orientations, some of you are already off to such a great start. Many of you have been hard at work preparing for today. Our student leaders, our teachers, administrators have all been hard at work to get ready. This is an exciting moment for all of us. So, I am so thrilled to be with you today. From what I saw this morning in the halls, in the pods, at carpool, girls getting out of their cars, you're excited too. You may not always show it, but I know you are. The excitement in this room is real, and I feel it in the air we are breathing. And my goodness, what a beautiful sight all of you are. We have, for the first time in our history, over 700 girls at Harpeth Hall. And that signifies our strength. And I would say that Harpeth Hall is a force, a good and positive force. And at the risk of ending the next sentence with a preposition, I'm even going to add that we are a force to be reckoned with. We are not to be ignored. We are 717 girls strong, and our strength comes from being in the midst of so many girls ready to learn and engage in a new school year. We are on the same team and signify that every day with our plaid, which signifies our team jersey. Before I go any further in our program, though, I want to introduce to you the people who are on the stage with me today. First, I'd like to introduce Ms. Judy O'Brien, director of the middle school and leader of the middle school. Ms. Armstead Lemon, director of the upper school. Josie Beavers, class of 2024, who will be our eighth grade speaker. And Margaret Bone, president of the student council and the leader of class of 2020 as well. There are 130 new to Harpeth Hall girls this year from 43 different schools. 10 of our new students, though, are not only new to Harpeth Hall, they're also new to Nashville. So I'd like to introduce them, and we'll give a round of applause at the end of each grade. How about that? So fifth grade, Charlotte Figler from Darien, Connecticut. Christine Haggerty back from Tokyo, Japan. Violet Williams from Chicago, Illinois. Let's give them a welcome. Seventh grade, we have Caroline Barker from Houston, Texas. Lily Barker from Houston, Texas. Tara Haggerty back from Tokyo, Japan. Nina Hartman from Huntington Beach, California. Emery Hess from Amsterdam in the Netherlands. Ashley Malakal from Summit, New Jersey. Let's give them a welcome. Ninth grade, we have Sydney Mattoon from White Plains, New York, and Lily Meyer from Brooklyn, New York. Let's welcome them. And 10th grade, we have Alexa Sheldon from Chatham, New Jersey. So we all have lots of new things to get used to, but these girls have an extra list of things to get used to, so we'll all welcome them. And now to our fifth grade, the 62 newest members, the class of 2027. You are our youngest bears in the Honey Bear Nation. Welcome. You have arrived at Harpeth Hall from 23 different schools. We know arriving at a new school is exciting and can be a bit overwhelming, but here's the good news. Your fifth grade teachers are here for you, your advisors are here for you, and you are in excellent hands. In addition, I extend a welcome home to our summer exchange travelers. For 5 weeks this past summer, Sabrina Knight and Bailey Grissom lived and studied in Johannesburg, South Africa, through our partnership with St. Stithian School. We are thrilled to offer a very warm welcome to Sabrina and Bailey's exchange sisters, Isabella Nibbs and Gisella Sittman. Who are joining us for the first quarter from St. Stithian's. Gisella and Bella, welcome, and we hope you have a great time at Harpeth Hall. This summer, Margot Dobbs and Maggie Hedera traveled to New Zealand and took classes at our sister school, Woodford House. We look forward to hosting two more students from Woodford House on campus during Winterham. Janet Briggs, Eva Christopher, Evie Naus, Ellie Nolan, Maya Roark, and Annie Stewart, accompanied by Mrs. Best, reciprocated their German exchange in June with a visit to Humboldt School in Wiesbaden, Germany, and took German language classes there. Again this year, we are excited to participate in an exchange relationship with a cohort of schools in Guatemala City, Guatemala. This summer, Claire Mendez and Clara Murph traveled to beautiful Guatemala, and later this fall, three more students from Guatemala will join us. In addition to Germany, Guatemala, New Zealand, and South Africa, our exchange program with the Legion of Honors Girls' School in Paris will enable Quinlan Sear to travel to France during Winterham. We will then host her exchange sister at Harpeth Hall in February. These exchanges are life-enriching opportunities, and I invite you to consider participating in an exchange. Also, get to know the exchange students that we host. New friends from around the world are coming to Harpeth Hall, eager to learn and eager to meet all of you. And now, please join me in welcoming our new faculty and staff who are new to Harpeth Hall this year. We are so excited about these wonderful additions to our faculty. First, Ms. Elsa Davids, middle school science teacher. Ms. Davids, could you just, there she is over here, stand in the way, thank you. Ms. Amy Dixon, upper school counselor. She's right over here. Ms. Elizabeth Floyd, communications manager. There she is in the back. Ms. Tanya Ford, middle school administrative assistant. Ms. Carolyn Frazier, upper school art. In the back, thank you. Ms. Olivia Heller, upper school history, right over here to the side. Ms. Tracy Long, middle school math, right over here. Ms. Allegra Rumbo, middle school science. She's in the back over here. And Mr. Lyndon Taylor, security manager, and he may still be out dealing with carpool, I'm not sure, but we'll give him a welcome anyway. Okay, as I said, this room is filled with girls who are eager and ready to learn, and I have to just give a shout out to two particular grades. One is the eighth grade, because you are the leaders of the middle school this year. It's such an important time. You will assume a highly important, invisible role, and the fifth, sixth, and seventh grade students are watching you, and I know that you will lead well and assume this with confidence and enthusiasm. My last welcome, can't believe I'm here, right here, with all of you, front and center. Class of 2020, welcome to your long-awaited senior year. You have earned this place in the front rows of the theater. And you're gonna help us go with the flow in 2020, I hear. And I'm so glad we are gonna have a year where we will be surfing along. We will learn so much from you this year. And whether you consider yourself a leader or not, guess what? You are. Everyone will be watching you as well. And I know I loved being with you on Monday at your workshop. I loved being with many of you at the Leadership Day yesterday. I feel like we're in really good hands with you as our leaders this year. Thank you and welcome 2020. Let's hear it for 2020. As we begin the school year, I wanted to share with you something that's been on my mind a lot, and that is the anniversary, and I know all of you know this, the anniversary that our country celebrated this summer on June 20th, the 50th anniversary of the Apollo 11 moon landing. It's a strange way to start the year, but it is just something that stuck with me. You see, I'm old enough to actually remember being a young girl at the time. I remember that my family, I remember that night, I remember us walking down the street to share the excitement with our neighbors. We all watched it at one of our neighbors' houses on TV, the kind of TVs that looked more like pieces of furniture than they do now. I remember making a model of the lunar module that summer, and I was so proud of the way I put the stickers on and the foil and everything just right. But what I didn't know at the time was how close we came to not making it to the moon. All I ever heard in 1969 was excitement and pride in our country for going to the moon first. Going first meant, at the time, going before the Soviet Union. However, plenty of people thought it was too much money for us to be spending on space exploration and science discovery. They thought that during the Vietnam War, we should be doing other things and spending our money in other ways. But President Kennedy at the time described our space exploration as inexorable. He gave a rousing speech at Rice University. "We choose to go to the moon," he said. "We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things not because they are easy, but because they are hard. They are hard. Because that goal will serve to organize and measure the best of our energies and skills. Because that challenge is one that we are willing to accept, one we are unwilling to postpone, and one which we intend to win." Point one this morning is that we can do hard things too. And frankly, right now, I can't think of anything the people in this room, the girls in this room, couldn't accomplish if we all worked together. The country took a risk in trying to get to the moon first. I want to invite all of us to take a risk this year. The good news is that we don't have to go to the moon. That's really good news. But we will do something that takes courage on our own scale, something that we have to take a risk in. And let's make sure to cheer each other on when we see one of our friends or classmates stepping out and taking that risk. Many of you know that Neil Armstrong was the astronaut who was able to be the first person to step foot on the moon. But here's the part of the story I didn't know until this summer when I started reading more about it. We almost didn't make it. Many people worked for decades to make the moon landing a reality. Some lost their lives in earlier missions and tests, but in the final moment, actually literally the final seconds, we almost crashed. The mission overshot their target on the moon, and the capsule was 2 to 3 seconds away from running out of fuel. The space module was right on top of an enormous crater, and if we didn't clear it, we would have crashed. Picture being in an airplane flying over the Grand Canyon and about to run out of fuel. That's what it was like. They got to the other side of the canyon in the final second of having fuel. The will and determination of Neil Armstrong saw the mission through to completion. He had the grit to stick with it. He kept his head in a terrifying moment. I have a card on my desk which says, "The road to success is short and smooth." And then in very small print it says, "Said no one ever." Girls, you are getting ready to embark on a wonderful year at Harpeth Hall. I promise it will be challenging at times, it will be fun at times, it will be mundane here and there, and other times a bit overwhelming. The other good news is that you will be supported and led through the tough times by your incredible teachers, your advisors, your friends, your classmates, and yes, by the older girls in this room. We want you to take risks, make mistakes, and I hope there will be many. You will have time to learn whatever the thing is that is hard to learn right now. Remember that we are all on this continuum of learning, and you know what I'm getting ready to say. You just may not be good at it. Let's fill in the blank with whatever we want to say. You may not be good at it yet. I want to encourage you and let you know that you can do hard things. And while you are here, trying and trying again, you will be noticed. Along the way, you will be seen, you will be heard, and you will be valued. Never underestimate your grit and determination, and never underestimate the power of the girls in this room. We support each other in our journeys. I'm so grateful to be beginning this school year and on this journey to the moon with all of you. Thank you. And now it is my pleasure to introduce Josie Beavers and ask her to come up to the podium and share her thoughts with you this morning. Josie, thank you.
My name is Josie Beavers from the class of 2024. It is my honor to represent our middle school as Student Activities Chair on Student Council and share some remarks with you today. Some of you might know that I love to write stories. Nothing else gives me the thrill like putting pencil to paper. To be honest, I got kind of giddy just writing this speech. With writing, I have the chance to thoughtfully choose each aspect and decision my characters make. Sadly, in life we don't have this luxury, but the basic idea is still the same. The story is ours to write, and the choices are ours to choose. So today, we are cracking open the first page of our 2019-2020 story. For some, it's the first chapter at a new school, and for others, it's the continuation of their Harpeth Hall series. Either way, I know that these next 9 months will be unforgettable. So let's get started, because we've all got stories to write. Honestly, the hardest part of the school year is the beginning. Everything's unfamiliar, your skirt is itchier than you remember, and you begin to question if English actually is your first language. You crash from the summer fun back to reality, and you are desperate for that final bell to ring. But something that will make your first quarter easier is to ask questions, lots of questions. Just remember that your teachers are here to help you. In fact, think of them as all-knowing wizards, who, in my opinion, are an essential for any great story. My second piece of advice is to be fearless. There is no harm in trying out for a sports team, auditioning for a play, or talking to somebody new. I speak from experience when I say it is better to regret having tried something than to regret having not tried it. The first quarter will be gone in the blink of an eye, and it will be time for the second and the third. By now, your teachers and classmates will know you and what to expect from you. Which leads us to the driving point of every story, especially this school year, struggle. No one looks forward to it in literature or in life because it forces us to grow. Being new to Harpeth Hall last year, I felt pressure for myself to be the best. I was always putting in an unnecessary amount of effort when, in reality, no one was watching my every move. But struggle comes in many different forms. For some, it might be friendship hiccups or academic disappointments or a variety of other things. But regardless, the beauty of struggle is that it can be overcome. So try not to spend a ton of time worrying about the little details, but rather focus on enjoying yourself and living in the moment. After those quarters fly by, it will be time for the final chapters. By now, everyone is stressed about exams or ERBs or just ready for summer to come again. But the most impactful moments and stories are often found in the last pages. These last months are the opportunity to grow in your friendships, solidify your academics, and spend time doing the things that you love. And here comes some cliche fourth quarter advice. Finish strong. Sometimes our brains switch into vacation mode, but ladies, I urge you, don't let it happen. But in those moments of weakness, just remind yourself that you've been working hard all year long. Every great character is motivated, just like each girl here. And before we know it, our school year story will have reached the end. I hope that this year will be one that you love to reflect upon, one that you cherish and keep in your library of thought. In conclusion, our year is what we make it to be. Ask questions, be fearless, enjoy yourself, and finish strong. I hope that this story, this year, is one that prepares you for a beautiful journey. So, we all have the task of authoring our own stories this year. What do you want yours to say? Thank you.
Thank you, Josie. And I think the next one really needs no introduction, but Margaret Bone will be our next speaker. Thank you.
Aloha, honey bears. Summer might be over, but surfing season has just begun. I'm Margaret Bone, and I have the honor to be your student council president this year. I'm also extremely lucky because I'm in the totally rad class of 2020. So, as the senior theme goes, I encourage you all to go with the flow in 2020. But I'm going to be honest with you guys, going with the flow is not really something that comes naturally to me. If what I'm doing is not planned out, or I don't think it will be perfect on the first try, I will procrastinate. And I'm not talking puts off summer reading until the last week of summer. I'm talking extremes. But there is something to be said in the way procrastination has prompted me to confront my perfectionistic tendencies head on. For instance, in history last year, we had Civil War causation papers due first thing on a Monday morning. We were given plenty of notice, even library days to work on it. But the more I wrote, the more I backspaced. And I opened my computer Sunday night to a shell of a thesis. The majority of my night was spent planning my paper and trying to find out where to put in primary or secondary sources. That night I fell asleep with only an outline. I woke up at 3:30 a.m. in a sweat. And I ran downstairs, hurled a coffee pod into our coffee maker, and threw caution to the wind, like I had any other option. I just started writing. I wasn't worried if the words were perfect because I simply didn't have the time. At 5 a.m., I started the editing process, half awake. After a brief nap, I put the final touches on my paper, whipped into school at 7:58, and handed that paper in on time, to everyone's surprise. And while this was not the first or last time I would confront this type of situation, a valuable lesson is to be learned. Not the obvious lesson that starting your work on time leads to productivity and calm in the long term, but that if I hadn't just gone with it and typed without worrying, my teacher and I would have had a very awkward conversation on Monday morning. I can overthink, and by just eventually breathing and writing, I didn't let myself get caught up in the details. Or perhaps time didn't let me get caught up in the details. While I do not recommend this approach, I do suggest getting the words out there without fear of failure. You have to trust yourself that you will fill in the gaps and have confidence in yourself. Harpeth Hall either has or will supply you with the skills you need for these tough situations, such as crafting a research paper the morning it is due. We are taught to be excellent problem solvers, and if you go with the flow, those skills will come organically. So going with the flow actually requires a lot of courage. I came to Harpeth Hall in seventh grade. I was entering a completely new environment, and I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do yet. Then the seventh grade Camp Laney retreat rolled around, and each cabin had to put on a skit. I was terrified, because my cabin decided our skit was going to be, should have been a Margaret, as the odds placed two Margarets in one cabin. Two of my cabin mates would walk into our time machine, and Margaret Kirchner and I would come out, and everyone would sing, should have been a Margaret, go Margaret, go Margaret, go. That's right. Well, the Margarets busted a move in the front. I was terrified of what people would think of me, which is strange now, considering I wouldn't think twice about singing and dancing in front of my class. I was given what you could call a reverse pep talk. Instead of my friends telling me, you can do it, it was more, just be chill about this. The question wasn't whether or not I could do it, but was I going to let my own self get in the way of my enjoyment? This year, I encourage you all to ask yourself the same question. You are no doubt capable, so it is up to you to just sit back and enjoy. Now I would like to give you all a little inspiration to use when it comes to going with the flow. As you progress through your year, I want to remind you that relaxing, taking positive risks, and embracing challenges as they arise will help you navigate your grade with confidence and calm. Fifth grade, welcome to Harpeth Hall. Fifth grade is a special year because you're all in the same boat, because all your peers are new honey bears. My advice to you would be similar to the message of Disney's The Little Mermaid. Although you may be the youngest, work to find and use your unique voice, especially about what matters to you. And I want to leave you with my all-time favorite quote by director Jennifer Lee, be fearless in pursuit of what sets your soul on fire. Sixth grade. When you're down, you're probably feeling confident. My movie for you guys is Lilo and Stitch. After an exciting year together, you will get to know each other even better before your grade grows next year. Very similar to the Hawaiian concept of family that Lilo comes to know this year, your classmates will become more like sisters. Also, shout out to my best friend who happens to be my sister, Simmons, I love you. Seventh grade, whether you're figuring out a new space, new friends, or just a new floor of the middle school, Finding Nemo might feel like a familiar storyline. Your grade has grown quite a bit, and seventh grade brings a lot of navigating. If you feel lost this year, don't forget that you have friends around you just like Nemo did to help you find your way back. Eighth grade, welcome to your first taste of being the oldest. While working hard and taking on more responsibility, don't forget to have fun as the leaders of the middle school. While not a movie, I decided to give you guys a TV show that embodies the fun of eighth grade. H2O, just add water. So come on, this is your adventure, and this is your fantasy. It's all about living in eighth grade, wild and free. Freshmen, welcome to high school. Freshman year comes with a lot of new things, and today you may feel like you've been waiting on your first day of high school since Taylor Swift released 15. If you're looking for a movie to take comfort in this year, I suggest Moana. It may feel like a long and crazy journey, but just as Moana ultimately found comfort in her own identity, ninth grade will teach you a lot about yourself. 10th grade, Sophomores, this is a unique year. While you're not a true high schooler, you still aren't quite an upperclasswoman. My advice to you guys is just sit back and enjoy this year, similar to the fun songs of Teen Beach Movie. When I think back of the masterpiece that is Teen Beach Movie, I don't actually remember the plot. I just remember all of the dance moves to Cruisin' for a Bruisin'. Looking back, I don't remember how many spring break sweatshirts we sold, but how fun it was to be the oldest on campus during Winterum and the excitement of everyone beginning to get their license and bond over the gravel lot. Also, another shout out to the funniest person I know, who knows me better than I know myself, Ace, I love you. Juniors, I'm gonna cut right to it. My movie for you guys is Endless Summer, because junior year may start to feel like anything but an endless summer. Beginning the college process, planning prom, and taking challenging classes, on the surface, junior year may feel like a lot of responsibility, but you guys have tons of fun. There's nothing like the thrill of being an upperclasswoman or the excitement the morning of prom reveal. And ladies, I know everyone warns you about junior year, but don't believe the hype. You really grow with your class, and you've been given the skills and tools to handle anything that comes your way. Now, before I get to our surfing seniors, there are still some people in our Harpeth Hall community I have yet to mention. To our amazing faculty, while I don't have any advice for you all, because you don't need it, I did want to offer a movie, Jaws. Not like that, because our faculty is classic and timeless. Arguably one of the best movies I've ever seen. Seniors, my movie for us was my favorite movie growing up, Free Willy. Well, yes, for you this may translate quite literally, as you are excited for the freedom of senior privileges or college on the horizon. The movie's central message is about the unlikely bond of a young boy and a whale. Whether it was prom build or late nights in the library before exams, we've bonded in a way that is so unique, and now we can sit back and enjoy the relationships we've cultivated. I'm gonna be completely honest with you all. The idea that I mentioned earlier, that going with the flow requires courage, really frightens me. I've always struggled with confidence in myself, and thus I assumed I wasn't a confident leader. In fact, when I ran for student council president, I didn't even tell my parents because I didn't want to let them down if I didn't win. But yesterday during our leadership retreat, the confidence committee helped us break down what makes up a confident leader, listing positive leadership traits such as hardworking, organized, and tenacious. I realized just because I may lack some traits doesn't mean I don't possess others, equally important ones. I can be and am a confident leader. What is a weakness for me is a strength for someone else and vice versa. I love that this concept is one we emphasize here. It's what makes Harpeth Hall the community it's loved for. I like to think I'm hardworking and ambitious, even if it kicks in the last minute. How else would I have turned in that Civil War paper? And if I'm lacking confidence in a particular arena, I know that there are girls in this audience that have that as a strength. And some really special girls in this audience that have the same confidence in themselves that they have in others. So this year, remember, you can go with the flow, because you are surrounded by peers who know your struggles and still accept you for who you are. Thank you, and surf's up.
Thank you, Margaret and Josie. And now I'd like to turn it over to Ms. O'Brien, who will be followed by Ms. Lemon.
Good morning. This is one of my favorite moments of the year, and it's such a privilege to be here with all of you, especially with the seniors right in the front. A special welcome to all of our new Honey Bears. We're so glad that you're here at Harpeth Hall. It's a good day. Today marks a new beginning for all of us, whether you're starting your fifth grade year or your senior year, whether you attended new faculty orientation 2 weeks ago or 20 years ago. I hope that today is one where you're able to dwell on the possibilities for what lies in store in the year ahead. Our school's motto, "Let us lift up the mind and spirit," is one that has great meaning for many of us. We are so fortunate to belong to a community that values both intellectual pursuits and matters of the heart. A place where authentic and meaningful relationships provide a strong foundation for our work together. Let us lift up the mind and spirit reflects a vital aspect of our community, a place where the voices of girls and women are ever present and valued. It's a good time to be a girl, and it's a great time to be at Harpeth Hall. And one thing that I know for certain is that great things happen when women and young girls set an intention to support each other and are consistent in choosing to lift each other up, working deliberately to steer clear of the low roads, often paved by unproductive criticism, gossip, or other actions that tend to sap our energy and weigh us down. I think our motto can really help us. Let us lift up the mind and spirit. As we begin the year, I hope you'll have moments to reflect on what lifts up your mind and your spirit. Hold on to those thoughts and turn to those people throughout the year to celebrate your triumphs and navigate the challenges that inevitably are part of every year. For me, something that always lifts up my spirit is reading. I've always loved to read for as long as I can remember. I enjoy getting lost in a great novel or in immersing myself in an autobiography or a history book. And this summer, as part of our Reading Choice initiative, I chose a book by Melinda Gates entitled The Moment of Lift. I was eager to read it because some friends had recommended it to me and because Gates is the co-chair of the largest philanthropy in the world. And because I was somewhat familiar with her commitment to addressing and understanding global issues. And so, when I picked up the book, I immediately went to, my eye was drawn to this phrase and sentence, how can we summit a moment of lift for human beings, and especially for women? Because when you lift up women, you lift up humanity. I was sold. I really enjoyed the book. Melinda Gates said she wrote the book after traveling the world for decades and realizing that if you want to lift society up, you have to turn your attention to issues that are keeping women down. In the book, she shares many stories of the women she met, as well as her own life experiences and how they shaped her perspective on what she feels are the most important issues facing women around the world. I'd like to share an idea that I highlighted in the book and one that I can't seem to get out of my mind. It reads, love is the most powerful and underused force for change in the world. For me, love is the effort to help others flourish. And it often begins with lifting up a person's self-image. And so, I continue to think about that idea, the power of love as a force for change. It's one that I can really get behind. And I think it our motto, lift up the mind, let us lift up the mind and spirit, is such a wonderful reflection of that sentiment. So here's for a great year filled with love, challenges, risk-taking, and friendship. Thank you.
Good morning. It is so good to be here and to look out on this sea of plaid with some surfer mixed in too. I have to confess, every time the seniors rush into convocation, it never fails. I tear up. There is just something special about watching this exuberant tradition. I think it is because it is a moment of pure becoming. You, class of 2020, are officially becoming our senior class today, and you are boldly seizing your moment with flair and joy. Yes, you are also on the verge of becoming adults too, but there is a youthfulness on display in this moment that I hope you never lose, that we all benefit from being around. This morning, you are modeling for us what it can look like to lead confidently. And you have an entire community behind you, cheering you on. Surf's up indeed. I had a similar reaction watching our World Cup champion American women's soccer team seize moment after moment on the field this summer and celebrate their wins and their team unabashedly. I was struck by the way they jumped for joy when they scored and spread their arms wide as if to say, "We are worth celebrating." Their full confidence in each other, their team's talent, and their ability to become world champions, again, was something to behold. And it begged the question for me, what does it mean to lead confidently as girls and young women in 2019-2020? What's on the horizon for us? And what are the many ways that leading confidently can look like? What I love about this school and our community is that we exist so that you, each of you, can become unabashedly you. So that as we launch out on our new year, you have the opportunity to explore and define what it feels like and looks like to lead confidently as a girl in your own way. Sometimes it might look like a roar of excitement, as it did for some of us this morning, and sometimes it might look like a quiet calm when your world feels stormy. Sometimes, many times, it looks like vulnerability, which is the willingness to be brave and say what is true for you, especially when it feels risky or uncertain to do so. An example of vulnerability might be turning to your assembly neighbor and admitting, "I'm a little nervous today," if that is true for you. And guess what? Being a little nervous on your first day means that you are ready. Being a little nervous is a good sign of what's to come. Whatever leading confidently looks like to you, I would wager that it always goes hand in hand with thinking critically and living honorably. These are character traits that will never go out of style. So I wish you each a wonderful year ahead, full of roars and quiet calms and courageous vulnerability, lots of opportunities as well to go with the flow. Let's keep the conversation going about what it looks like for young women to lead confidently in 2019-2020 and show our community and beyond the many ways that our Honey Bear Nation leads well. Thank you.
And now it is about that time. I want to thank you all for your enthusiasm this morning and for all of the remarks from everyone on stage. Thank you all. And before we dismiss, I'd like to invite the seniors to come on stage and lead us in the alma mater.